Hey, it's Mike here, one go short play, playing Beast Warriors for the Sega Mega Drive. I don't know why I'm doing a stupid voice for each of the titles. Playing Beast Warriors for the Sega Mega Drive. Sorry about that. It is ridiculous. I'll try not to do it. It's one of those things I don't really notice I'm doing, you know. For domestic title, Airhole. Oh, I see. I think I played this. Is this like a wrestling game like that? Beast Wrestler, whatever it's called. What's that game on the arcade? I can't remember what it's called. The Data East one where you're wrestling against beasts. Ooh, transitions. I think this is going to be that sort of thing. I'm just letting the front end play out a bit so I can kind of see what... Get the atmosphere, you know. Beast Warriors. A little bit of an altered beast, kind of dark... organy music thing going on. I like that. I love Altered Beast. You all know that. People hate Altered Beast. I had a guy in yesterday fixing my boiler, and I've got this giant Altered Beast painting on the wall, which I did. A pixel painting, I call it. I basically bought a big 1 meter by 1 meter canvas years ago and used a frame of Altered Beast animation in the back. You know, I'll carry on with the game while I'm talking anyway. Used a picture of one of the characters. It was the tiger jumping. It was a frame that I quite liked. Ooh, cool. Select the character. Quite like him. They're all really ugly. It's a thing. It's that thing about don't use monsters and robots and insects in your game or people can't relate to them. And I kind of get it with this game because they're all pretty hideous. In fact, the one I'm more inclined to go for is that guy because he's quite human or he's like a giant in a suit. And that's just instinctively, I don't really want to go for cyclopses and winged things as someone to sympathise with. Does that make sense? So I can see what my old boss was saying. Player 2 can be as hideous as you like. I want the hideouser the better. He's quite small. I'm going to take him on. What was I saying? Oh, yeah. Yeah, him. Oh, no, I don't want air hole. Go back. Oh, I see it's B button to go back. Oh, I'm just... You know what? No. That's not what I picked. Let's do this again. I want robot dude who could be a human in a suit. And I'll take on... You know, I'm not taking on the little guy. I'm taking on that thing. Yes. A button, A button, A button. I've got issues with that as well. I was starting to mention it in the previous video, which I'll just go into now. B button sits in the middle. On the Amiga, you use the B button of a Mega Drive pad. Maybe it's because of that I'm accustomed to hitting B as my first button. But with this, you have to hit A. And B goes back. And that feels counterintuitive to me. That's all. So I always go for the B button, and when it goes back and takes you on a tour of the front end, I have a bit of an issue with that. This game does that. It's wrestling, but not very pacey and not very... See, this is like wrestling by numbers. It lacks pace, and no matter what I do on the controls, he gets the better of me. Like, I'm waggle the joystick. No, that didn't work. So let's wrestle again. Let's tap A. Oh, yeah. Tapping A really hard. All right, that did work. Okay, tap B. No, that didn't work. Okay, tap C. No, that didn't work. I think the A button is where it's at with this game. Oh, I'm going to take him down. Yes. Okay, now I'm just going to hit him on the floor as much as I possibly can. Have some steam in your face. Have some robot steam. Wobble his little chin for him. Okay, it's all about the A button. Tap that A button. Tap that A button. Tap that A button. Yes, hit him with the steam. Wobble his chin. Wobble his chin. Hit him with the steam. No, steam. Steam. Don't just punch the air. Jump on him. Jump on him. Yes. Pin him. Oh, you know, there's one flaw to my plan. I do not know how to pin. Is it that? Pin him. Come on. Just pin anything. Pin him. Oh, usually there's a pin button. Oh, nice. Okay, so Altered Beast. I love that game. I've got a massive big painting on my wall. Done with like paints. I made a palette out of the paints first. Painstakingly. And put them in like jars. Saved up jars and everything to do it. Get his little wobbly chin. And then... Uh-oh. Oh, yeah. I could so pin him now. Pin him? I'm going to lose because I don't know how to pin. What's that about? Instruction book. We know how we feel about instruction books. We like to smell them. And he went, that's doing my head in. What's that game there on that picture? The guy who came to fix me boiler said this. And he says, is it Altered Beast? I said, yes, it is. Well done. Wow, look at the tiny little people. These guys are huge, although rendered very small. I said, yeah, it is, as a matter of fact. Thinking, oh, someone who likes Altered Beast, a Kinder Spirit. He went, I hate that game. I was like, what? Why? How could you hate that game? People do hate that game, I know. But I was like, go on, why do you hate that game? And tries to get him to break it down. And he said his reason he hated it was because he couldn't get off the first level. Now, I'm not being funny. If you can't get off the first level of Altered Beast, you've got no business playing Altered Beast. You're really just not trying enough. It's that simple. It's very, very, very simple game. You kill things, you pick up stuff, and you get stronger, and then you fight a boss. And he couldn't quite get that, so he gypped it off. That said, the guy hasn't got a computer. By his own admission, he's a bit of a Luddite. So, fair enough. And I just did my head, and I thought, is that why people don't like Altered Beast? Because they couldn't be bothered to figure out how to turn into the beast and start kicking butt. Basically, I'm sure it's not. I'm sure it's because it is quite a simplistic game and it is quite crude in its way. But again, context, there was nothing really like it at the time, you know. And it's beautifully drawn when you think about the work that went into those sprites. You know, I've got a little soft spot for that game. I mean, I'm sure a lot of work went into these sprites, but let's face it, there's a 2-frame animation going on there from both sprites, and not a lot of them are moving. Do you know what I mean? There's not a lot of work on it, especially the robot dude. I mean, look, his little arm's going. I'm bored. I'm bored of the game as well. This is rubbish. But yeah, there's not a lot of animation. Go look at the animation and break it down. Okay, let's see. The big white dude with the wings. His reaction frame then was his head going back and his body stayed still. Those animators, that animator, to me, I would say, isn't enjoying animating. Oh, bullets in the face. That's just my opinion as someone who's animated characters for a game. This guy, I suppose he's competently done. They're competently done. They're all competently done. I mean, 4-frame animations, no movement from the middle of the body, except for, he's going to pin me now, isn't he? Except for arms and legs moving. I can understand when you're on a time constraint why you'd want to do that. But where's the joy, you know? Where's the joy in doing that 2-frame tail wobbling animation? It's clearly got a tail around me that is now just wobbling in 2 frames, and my reaction to that is to bounce up and down with just a little pixel of animation on the feet. I'm not being funny, but they could have done better than that. Even if it was just moving body parts around, they could have done better than that. And I just get the feeling there was no love. Considering the amount of interesting characters they've got in this game, I get the feeling there's not that much love put into it. Altered Beast, on the other hand, while there's not many animations per character, really, we're going to lie on the floor together here. Pillow talk. While there's not many animations per character, they're beautifully rendered with clearly a lot of love, and the sprites are nice and big. And I love the consistency of the idea, the design idea, along with the variety of the monsters. And, you know, they all have 2 moves, but they all have 2 different moves that are useful in different ways. He's thrown me and I'm running, apparently. But it was exactly the same animation as the walk. It was almost the same slow, boring speed as the walk. Same again. Oh, this is dull. I don't like this game. It's rubbish. The game I played where you're fighting monsters on the arcade, wrestling monsters on the arcade, the Data East one, I can't remember the name of, Beast something. Beast Buster? No, that's a different game completely. It might have been something like Beast Wrestler, Beast. I can't remember. It will come up at some point if I ever cover MAME, which I probably will. I have the game on the arcade machine that I've built, and I might stick a camera on that at some point and, you know, show off the games on it. But Beast Wrestler, I don't know. But that game was a better game than this, with bigger sprites, bigger wrestling ring, smoother animations, smoother controls. Well, you have to be when they're on an arcade, don't they? Because you only get 1 attempt and you put your money in, you know. Something's happening. I don't know what it is. Pin him then. Oh, paused it. Pin him. Slap him about then. I'm just slapping him now. Oh, dull. Okay, time's up, thank goodness. That was Beast Warriors for the Sega Mega Drive, and I don't really like it. Could you guess? Thanks for watching.